Hi, I'm Joe Levy. I'm an assistant professor in the geology department here at Colgate University, and ice is my favorite rock. A lot of people think that geology is just coal and gas and granite, but that's not the case. Actually, geology tells us about how the climate system interacts with the Earth's surface, where we all live. So half the year, I'm a permafrost geologist. I study frozen ground in Antarctica and Alaska. I study retreating coastlines and melting communities. The other half of the year, I'm a Martian. I'm working with scientists at NASA to uncover the history of glaciation and permafrost growth on the Red Planet. So I'd like you to come in and take a look at one of these projects that's supported by the Mars Data Analysis Program. Most people don't know that Mars is covered in glaciers, and there's good reason for that. They're covered in debris, in rock and sediment, and so when you look at the surface, you can't see them. But with orbiting radars, you can. So we're zooming in now on a composite of thousands of images of the Martian surface that's overlaid over some topographic data. So red is high ground, blue is low ground. And we're zooming in on one of these glaciers. Now, these debris-covered glaciers are old. Some of them are hundreds of millions of years old, some are a billion or more. So the more we zoom in, the more we see. The more we see the structure of the glacier and the soil on the top deforming away. And we can actually zoom all the way down to the individual boulder scale. And so the students that I work with in my lab are out every day doing glaciology on Mars, zooming in as close as they can to these incredible data sets and actually looking at and measuring the properties of individual Martian boulders that are telling us the history of glacier flow on Mars. So who cares about glaciers on Mars? Landforms like these tell us about Martian climate history, and the search for warmer, wetter conditions on Mars is the search for life on the Red Planet. We want to understand when Mars went from being warm and wet to cold and dry like it is today. And so the search continues.